If you've ever read or watched the news from overseas media sources, then you've probably heard that people from across the globe are facing serious challenges. You also probably know that there are currently several ongoing conflicts occurring across the globe. One name that has been consistently showing in the news cycle for its ongoing conflicts is Palestine. You might have heard the name from the location of the deadly train derailment in East Palestine, Ohio, that has devastated the local community.
Burning wreckage of a freight train could explode, sending shrapnel and toxic fumes a mile in every direction over a rural Ohio community.
But for most people, Palestine refers to the land of Palestine located in the Middle Eastern region. It is also known as the geographical location of the deadly Palestinian-Israeli conflict, which has been ongoing for over 70 years. It has displaced millions and inflicted many thousands of casualties, and it currently has no end in sight.
The first intifada was sparked by the deaths of four Palestinians in December 1987. By the time it ended in 1993, more than 1,100 people had died. 16,000 people had been detained.
From the perspective of an average Texan college student, we don't pay too much attention to news about conflicts from across the globe. What happens in Palestine doesn't really affect the typical Texan lifestyle. As long as Texans can go to the city, get some drinks, watch the Cowboys game, or ride our horses around, then Texans aren't likely to pay close attention to what happens in Palestine anytime soon. However, did you know that there is a Palestine located in Texas? I was recently looking at a map of Texas, trying to figure out what to research for this video project. To my surprise, I noticed that Palestine is the name of a city in East Texas. As a person with Palestinian heritage, I wanted to take a closer look. I asked myself, how did this East Texas city end up with the name of a place that is so geographically far away from the original land of Palestine? Who first came to settle in Palestine, Texas? And what does the history of this place look like? As a result of my research, I discovered the beginnings of modern-day Palestine can be traced back to the Parker family, who hailed from Palestine, Illinois. The most prominent settlers in this family were John Parker and his son Daniel Parker. Daniel Parker was a preacher known for his views as a conservative primitive Baptist, also known as Old School Baptism. He was John Parker's eldest son. After a schism among his followers in Illinois, Daniel Parker sought to bring his church down to Texas. After failing to get permission from the Mexican government, the Parkers were invited by Stephen F. Austin to organize and establish a colony for Daniel and his church. John Parker, Daniel Parker's followers, and over 30 members of the Parker clan drove down to Texas by ox wagons in the year 1833. After arriving in Texas, Daniel Parker promptly established the Old Pilgrim Church near present-day Elkhart, considered to be the first Protestant church in the history of Texas. Daniel Parker's father John was a frontiersman who had fought in the Continental Army during the American Revolution. The elderly John Parker is mostly remembered for directing the establishment of Fort Parker with the rest of his familial clan in the spring of 1834. It became the site of the infamous Fort Parker Massacre on May 19, 1836, in which John and several of his family members were ambushed and killed by a large group of Comanche Indians. A young Cynthia Ann Parker was kidnapped and raised by her captors, growing up to become a full-fledged Comanche herself. Years later, she would give birth to Quanah Parker, the last Comanche chief who fought battles against soldiers on the Texas plains. Okay, so we know about who the first people who settled in modern-day Palestine, Texas. But who gave the city its name? According to the sources from the city of Palestine, it was in fact Daniel Parker who suggested that the new county seat be named Palestine. Despite this seemingly obvious conclusion, as I continued researching this topic, I found that there was information that contradicts this narrative. The entry on the Texas historical marker for a settler named Micah Main states that he and John Parker were both specifically appointed to establish a site for the county and give it a name. It concludes that early histories of Anderson County credit Micah Main for naming the new county seat Palestine for his former residence in Illinois, but later accounts credit John Parker for this action. Primary source materials that could verify this claim have not surfaced. Despite the information on the historical marker, John Parker's death occurred in 1836 during the Fort Parker Massacre, which means he could not have been alive to survey the land with Micah Main a decade later. With all these considerations in mind, I believe that the official naming of Palestine, Texas could be credited to either preacher Daniel Parker or settler Micah Main, or perhaps both. Okay, so we have a good idea of who named Palestine, Texas, and that it's named after the city of Palestine in Illinois. Now I want to know, why was the city in Illinois named Palestine? For this explanation, I'm going to leave it to local Palestine historian John Lamb to break down the etymology of the word Palestine and how it became the name of a city in East Texas.
Well, here I am in Palestine, Texas with John Lamb. He's taught school for 30 years. He owns a building downtown and he's an overall good guy. So that qualifies him to tell us why Palestine is Palestine. So John, why is Palestine Palestine?
Palestine was named Palestine by the founders who came here from Palestine, Illinois. But Palestine, Illinois, in its turn, was actually named after the Philistines because the Hebrew word for Philistines, that we call Philistine, that's the English word, was Philistine. And so it's the Hebrew pronunciation of what we call Philistines because the area in Illinois reminded the explorer Jean Lamont, the explorer thought it looked like the land of milk and honey.
Well, I heard about the Palestine railroaders bringing it down from Palestine, Illinois, but I didn't know about that Hebrew translation. Thanks a lot, John.
Thank you for watching my video project. I hope you learned something interesting about the city of Palestine.